How's it going, everyone? My name is Ron and welcome back to another video. Today we're just going to be doing some more shading in the soft fashion. So today what we're going to be using is my good old Cheyenne Hawk Thunder 4mm stroke direct drive. We're using some high-end cartridges this time, guys. A Bugpin 9 soft edge quadrant in the long taper. And a Bishop Da Vinci Bugpin 15 curve mag in the long taper. So I'm just going to try to keep it to where I only kind of set myself a little personal challenge here to where I only need to use these two mags. So if I need to get into the tight spots, I can challenge myself and use the corners. Our ink setup this time is a little different as well. For our blackest black is just straight world famous triple blackout. We have a 75% mixture, 50% mixture, a 6 drop, and a really, really light 1 drop. And I put 1 drop of dynamic white in my 4 washes. Just 1 drop. Just to kind of go outside the comfort zone a little bit, and I think you'll maybe be surprised at the different results that kind of come out of it as well. So let's see, I got my 75, 50, and 6 and 1. I kind of left out the 3. I'm going to try to stick to my 75, 6, and 1, and I can kind of use my 50% to blend in if I need to go darker and or... just darker, I suppose. If I need to go a little bit darker than my 6, I can dip into this one and go darker. A little bit bigger flower this time. I have not put my little leaf lines in yet, but I figured I can just do that later. Maybe we can do that together on cam. But bigger flower, guys. So it's probably going to be a longer video. Hopefully I have enough memory to capture all of this. So, and I actually just realized that I forgot a cup of water, so let me grab that. We have our reference photo here that I just shaded on Procreate and printed off for just for the cause of the reference. Cool. So once again, we're going to emulate this onto this the best we can. If it turns out great, if it doesn't turn out great, if it does, awesome. So alright, so as always, let's start with our leaves, alright? So I think what we'll do is just let's start with the quadrant here. I also have the light set up just a little bit differently so you guys can see better. That way the shadow is not as bad, which good, it's not. So, alright, so let's start with our triple blackout here. Put down our inkies. Thank you. I'm just getting a little warmed up here. It does take me a second to get cracking. That's a really uncomfortable position. Using our corner here again. Get some straight black in there. Boy, this triple blackout is very messy. I'm going to try my best not to turn the skin either. That's the point of today's video, I suppose, is just going out of our comfort zone to try to better ourselves. I've already got it darker there than I want, but I'm just gonna roll with it. Oh Lord, not very smooth. Right. Good as we're gonna get in. I don't wanna go too heavy. I do say this triple blackout is very, very messy. Alright, that's about as good as we're gonna get it. Alright, let's see here. Let's give us just a rinse here. Power down. There we go. The old quadrant of brake. Now, of course, leave it up to me to change up what works for me. but it's, you know, it's a curse to always just want to try new things, right? Let's dip into our six here. We just fucking splashed it everywhere. We're hanging about there. I don't know if you guys can see, just barely hanging out of the cartridge. That's the thing about those quadrant mags too, is that if you don't, you can only get them so far sucked in before they start to chatter. All right, so let's just start blending, I guess. Put some shit on here. Thank you. Quick flash in the 50. I'll come in here and kind of give it another dip in the 6, and we'll just try to smooth this out the best we can. So I do have to say, I usually always put at least 3 drops of white in, and it really does help make your ink more opaque. Why I'm really struggling right here, but especially with the 15, I usually don't use a, usually I'm using a 9 and an 11. All right, let's hit our 6 here. I guess we'll just try to watched David Vega live stream. It wasn't an actual live stream, it was a recording of a live stream. Damn, I already went too deep on that one. And it kind of inspired me to do this. Let's try to enter the skin already moving. Give it one or two passes right here just to kind of because we're gonna get it. Not the best I've seen, not the best I've done, but oh well. David Vega, when he does it too, he hangs those needles out there too, and that's really, that's when it's just all about hand control, you know? That is just years and years and years of perfecting your craft. Just something to definitely admire. Let's try to blend this out the best we can. I'm already wiping that out too much. Well, that's why we're here. We're here to learn, here to practice. Let's do the same thing here, a couple backstrokes. That seems to really be working. And we're already kind of absconding from the way our reference photo is, but I'm in savior mode now. Let's do one more click out here. Guys, you guys been out of focus this whole time. So not exactly the results I was expecting. Well, in a way, I guess. I did know that adding only one drop would make things a lot. Adding only one drop of white would make things a lot more difficult to see, you know? For lack of a better word, I guess. No. We're just gonna leave it. It's because I feel like if I touch it anymore, it will, just end up looking worse. Alright, so we're going back to our 9 soft edge here. We're gonna leave them hanging out. About like so. You guys can see that. And let's go, let's dip into our 75. I'm just gonna start brushing this in here. Going on, guys? Welcome back. So I made a mistake. I thought I was recording for an hour and 40 minutes, but it was only an hour. So silly me. I also decided that I was going to grab a 1013. I feel like this 1015 just might be a little too big for me personally. I know some of you guys, let me turn on my light here. I know some of you guys would rather have, 1015s. Comes out smoother, but I'm just so much more comfortable with a 9 and a 13 than I am a 15, so. Sounds weird, I know, but this is how I roll. So, let me put my cups up here. So, I'd say that's probably done for, huh? Let's throw that in the trash. Let's fill up some more cups of water here. All right, let's get cracking here. So, it's not looking too shabby. I mean, it's definitely not my best work, but it does kind of have a more of a not as like silvery look as I like, as I'm used to. So I'm not gonna let that detour me from finishing. So it's let's see, where were we? Where were we? So we're on this guy here. So I suppose we'll, excuse my squeaking chair here. Let's just go through, we'll put our blacks in, and then we'll go through and finish up. Now I almost pulled out a Mass Pro 13 because it has a medium taper on it, and I feel like that would go better with our blacks, but we'll be fine. We'll be fine. How's that looking? I can't believe how black this triple black is sometimes. It's like, how do they do it? Right, let's move on here. Well, I tell you, it'd be really nice to have that 7 right now. So so let's jump over here to our 10-13. I suppose. Thank you. cross hatching on the short end. Hit our 75 here. Let's start back over this way, I suppose. Now, I'm already liking how this cartridge is putting it down, you know what I mean? That probably means it's a shorter taper, which would explain why I like those precision mags so much. I just figured out that they're like a 3.5 taper. Go on, jump in our 6 here. I gotta grab some more bubble gum. I gotta grab some more inkies here, guys. Give me one sec. Let's go with 6, and then maybe a flash in our 50. There we go, now we're moving. Let's see here. Let's do 6 and 75. Thank you. Let's switch back to our quadrant 9, I suppose. Although I feel like that precision 9 would do me a lot better right now. We'll go into our lightest one and blend some of this out. Sometimes it takes me a few passes to find my groove. We're gonna hang out the needles a little bit more this time to see if that puts it down a little bit faster. I like it a lot. Let's keep going in our six here, or one drop, and we'll push out some of this darker stuff with this lighter stuff. Crosshatch there. Sometimes it takes me a little while to find the groove, guys, but we're fucking cooking now. I always find myself just overthinking a lot of this shit, and that's why, like, most of the time I'm just like, you know, I come back around to just, you know, keeping it as simple as possible, and that always works out the best for me. But yeah, I took a little break and I was like, well, maybe that 15 is just too big for what I'm used to. I'll grab a 10-13. Then, that's when I kind of just figured out that these Grabit cartridges must have a much shorter taper than these long tapers. And you know, it's not the absolute smoothest shading, but it's shading nonetheless. My dog right now is giving my wife hell. I can hear him in there trying to wrestle her. Alright, so, well, we just dipped in our one drop, so we might as well use it up real quick, and then we'll dipped again. I didn't even realize it. So, let's get our cartridge cleaned out. And we'll, Yeah, we're making much, much better time. Oh, I'm sitting on the edge of my seat. And we'll, back over here to this side real quick. I'll go 50, 75. jump over here and our, let's do our, jump in our six here real quick. Thank you. Plug our 9 back in. Jump over here in our... Wow. That's how you stab yourself right there. Jump in here, door 1. Smooth this out a little bit. Thank you. That's a really uncomfortable position. Make it a little darker around here, that way we can that way our inner leaf right here pops a little bit more. Backstroke some 75 in there. Well, it's not perfect by any means, but it's about right where I want it. Alright, let's move on. Let's stick with our 9 here. Jump in here to our I'd say 6, I guess. right, so let's jump back over here to our six, I suppose. Give it a quick stir. It's recording in black and white. Is it black and white on your guys' end? It must be because I have it plugged in. Let's try something. Oh yeah, it's because I have it plugged in. Mm-hmm. to make doors 9. We've gone over this so many times that I'm sure if it was somebody, it would be hamburger meat by now, but depending on where it was at anyway. Thank you. How's that for corner action? Turn it down just a little bit here. Try to get this center mark out. Thank you. goes, we're gonna get it. Shoot, dang, what do we got left? Leaves? We don't get this so much done. I'm gonna brush. I'm gonna take my lightest gray. Brush this edge in right here. Got the needles hung out just a little bit further. If you can tell, but it's thumping it pretty hard. Thank you. Should have started doing it that way. Start with my gradient first and then work down to black, but so much better that way. My hand's starting to get a little sore here. Mm-hmm. There goes her image. Boy, I can taste the finish line.
Thank you.
We're here, we might as well do it. We'll just brush in some of this lightest gray on these leaves and then we'll call it a night. I am my hand is hurting. I'm squeezing this machine too tight. A terrible habit to get into, guys. Let's brush some of this shit in here just to smooth it out. So if you are going to put in, you know, go through and put in your lightest tone and you're working with like a gradient, just make sure you start brushing it in on your darkest spot, because if you start brushing it in on the edge of your second lightest tone, you're going to darken up that gradient. You're going to fuck up the whole thing. The whole gradient, you know what I mean? You're going to just mess up the, that effect you're trying to go for. And I don't know, I might just start brushing in the lightest tone with a shorter taper mag. I feel like you just have to go over it too many times with a long taper until I start to develop a stronger hand technique, more consistent hand technique, or I don't know, maybe hang the needles out further with the lightest tone to get it in there faster. Maybe that's what we should do next, experiment with. We already went on that one, didn't we? Oh, got the microphone on. Got some cool new bottle stickers from Etsy. Pretty cool, right? I bought some dynamic ones many, many months ago, and they just kind of started to wear out, so. Got some new ones off Etsy. Yeah, a company called Grape Labels off Etsy. Pretty cool, I thought. Oh my lord. Cool. Well, right on. Let me know what you guys think. Here is the finished thing here. Let me know what you guys think. Questions, comments, concerns, just holler at me. I'm here for all my subscribers. God bless. Love you all. Peace.